Hi everyone, this is Galen, design team member with Unity Stamp Company. Today I have four pages of scrapbook layouts and they coordinate and they are using a mix of mixed media techniques. I'm using stamping, stenciling, watercolor, embossing, and I'm fussy cutting, and I'm going to use various mediums all throughout. So for the stamping, I have seven kits by Unity. One is called Blow Your Mind and then Hug. I Am Who I Am, Say It With Love, Hey Friend, Time to Be Happy Again, and Summer Celebration. I'm using those stamps, elements from those kits all throughout the video. I have Versamark ink with Ranger gold embossing powder, and I have Ken Oliver Crafts color burst powders in grape jelly and razzleberry. I'm stamping in the Versamark ink on the smooth side of the watercolor paper. And then that gives a better impression. And then I stamp that in Versamark ink. And then I heat set that in gold using a heat tool there. And so I do the same thing with the sentiments and the flowers. I stamp them, try to maximize the amount of stamping I can get at one time. Using the original Misty for the embossing, and there you go. I use the sentiments the same way and stamped and heat embossed them the same way. And so I use a paper trimmer, a Fiskars paper trimmer, to just trim the panels from the decorated and colored cardstock that I use. So I'm going to stamp and I'm going to eventually watercolor all on these bigger panels, and then I will cut them later with a paper trimmer. And so using a Ranger craft mat, a plastic craft mat, and a spray bottle called a Mini Mister, I put a lot of water down. I spray a lot of water down on these panels first, and then I add tiny, tiny shakes and dabs of the color burst powders. You see, it's very, very vibrant. You don't really need very much powder down. And then when you add more spray water to that, it just really just pops and the color moves into all these beautiful patterns. I love it. And so with the excess there, it's a very messy project. With the excess, I just do some ink smooshing for the sentiment panels just to add color that's already down on that plastic craft mat. And I just dab it in there to color those panels. And so this, a little bit of this color goes a long way. So you leave it to set or heat set the watercolor. In the meantime, I'm going to go ahead and stencil some background patterns, sort of a background doily, two on a 12 by 12 piece of cardstock that I'm going to use as the base background for this, all the stamped and stenciled scrapbook panels. I'm going to do four. So I'm showing you one page, but I did all four pages the same way for the stenciling. I just go in with Distress Oxide ink and an ink blending brush and blend around that stencil and leaves a beautiful pattern. I have fossilized amber, worn lipstick, and wilted violet, and a little bit of walnut stain distress oxide inks. So then I use Ranger Archival ink to stamp some more accents from those kits I mentioned, and I like to make little borders on the sides, and these are great places to add photos or whatever it is you want to scrapbook. In my case, I'm using in the center, I'm going to use a collage photo in the center. And I like the framing on the edges like that. I added some splatters using stamps. And here are my trimmed pieces that I used paper trimming and fussy cutting to cut them out. This is what the stamping looks like after the watercolor is dried and you trim it. It's so pretty, so pretty. You can use things like this on cards as well. I decided for this, I'm going to use it for a scrapbook set of pages for a friend. And so there you go. I had foam tape on all of the panels, and I began by just taking the backing off of the adhesive and just sticking it right on there, the handmade stickers and elements for the scrapbook page. I just love it. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you take a moment to subscribe to my channel and share if you will. Thanks so much. Have a great day.